Learn to master the fill tool, clip studio paint, and lay down your colors faster and flawlessly by actually understanding how the tool works. Often we use a lot of fancy digital art tools without really knowing how they work. We just look at the result and assume that the results in the future will be similar. However, that is not always the case, and tweaking and tuning values of 5, 6, 7 different properties without getting the desired result is just infuriating. In this video, I will explain and demonstrate the functionalities of the fill tool and its subtools. Last year, I took a big step and transitioned from Photoshop to become a Clip Studio Paint artist, and one of the first features that blew my mind in Clip Studio Paint was the fill tool. So if you're coming from Photoshop or something similar, you're probably not even aware that a fill tool with the right properties can be such a game changer for your efficiency when you color your artwork. And if you're new here, hi, I'm Nadiaxel. I'm a professional self-taught digital artist, and this is Dew, my little fluffy assistant. You can follow me on Instagram at NadiaxelArt for general art updates and comics, or you can join my mailing list to always be the first to receive news about upcoming content, tips and tricks, discount codes, sometimes behind the scenes, whatever goodies I can really come up with. And be sure to subscribe to the channel if you're not already and hit the little ding-dong so you'll be notified of my uploads. Guys, it's time we dig into the tutorial. Accessing the fill tool and subtool properties. When you open Clip Studio Paint and select the fill tool in the toolbar, it's the bucket icon right here, you should be able to see two windows open up. A tool property window and a subtool window. If one or both windows do not show up, go to the window menu and make sure there's a check mark next to tool property and subtool. Your default settings probably look like this, and even if they don't, do not worry because we'll be changing the values around a lot anyway. Introducing the Lineart. Now I've opened a file containing the Lineart for my drawing. It's Jinx from Arcane, by the way, in case you didn't figure it out already, because I just binged that series and it's freaking awesome. If you look out here in the layers window, you can see that my Lineart is on its own layer and it's called Lineart. And below it is just a white background. How you decide to structure your layers is totally up to you. Sometimes I have all of my flat colors on the same layer, and sometimes I divide each section of the character into separate color layers. It really depends on the individual drawing and the artist's preferences, so do exactly how you want to. In this example, however, I am using one single layer for all of my flat colors, and I will just call it flats. So here is the demonstration and walkthrough of the magic of the fill tool in Clip Studio Paint. The refer multiple property, refer all layers. Select your flats layer or whatever your empty color layer is named and pick a color. Just make sure your color layer is below the Lineart layer. You can now fill in color by simply clicking an area inside your Lineart. Wait a minute, why does the fill tool color inside the lines when I am not on the same layer as my Lineart? If it's on a separate layer, how does it know where the lines are? Well, if you look in the properties window, you'll notice this property called refer multiple. When you activate this property, you can choose from all layers, reference layer, selected layer, and layer in folder. In my properties, I ask the fill tool to take all layers into consideration when it fills in colors. So all the layers you might have out here in your layers window will be taken into account when the fill tool is being used. Look what happens if I uncheck the refer multiple property. The fill tool now does not refer to any other layer than the current selected layer, so it just fills the entire layer with the same color because the layer was initially empty. Clicking the refer multiple property back on and selecting all layers simply means what you see is what the fill tool sees. Even if your line art is scattered in 5, 10, 20 different layers, if you can see it, the fill tool refers to it for guidance. The reference layer. Let's take this a step further and say you have outlined some background elements on a separate layer than your character. If you choose refer all layers and start coloring your background on a separate color layer for your background, of course, you'll notice that the color does not bleed all the way behind the character. For some people this is fine, but I would personally prefer the background to fill the entire canvas so I can move my character around later if needed without there being a big blank gap in the background colors. One way to avoid the blank gap would simply be to hide the Lineart layer with your character on when you're coloring the background. The fill tool can't see a hidden layer and you can always just turn it back on afterwards. However, this is not always a good solution, especially if you're working on bigger pieces with a lot of layers. So another way to get around this is to use a reference layer. Go back to your properties window and under refer multiple, select the little lighthouse icon, which is the reference layer option. Now go take a look in your layers window. Anything here look familiar? I'm waiting. Well, if you look closely at the top of the window, you'll see another icon with a lighthouse on it. Select the background layer and click on the lighthouse icon. Or you can right click on the thumbnail of your layer and select set as reference layer. See how the lighthouse now shows up on your layer? That means that now this layer is your reference layer. And if you now select your color layer for your background and go grab the fill tool, you'll see that the fill tool ignores all other layers except for your reference layer. In other words, what you see is this, and what the fill tool sees is this. And it doesn't matter how many different color layers you create, as long as the Lineart layer remains your reference layer, all the fill tool sees is this. Select the layer and layer in folder. The last two options of refer multiple are just other variants of what your fill tool refers to. Selected layer only refers to layers you click a little check mark on. It's like using a flexible reference layer that you can quickly turn on and off, and you can have multiple layers selected at the same time. Layer in folder only refers to the layers in the folder which you are currently working in. The close gap property. If you're like me and sometimes do not close off your Lineart completely, you'll likely have experienced the fill tool finding all of these little gaps and letting the color bleed through them onto the entire canvas, sending you on an hour-long search for small gaps in your Lineart to absolutely no one's pleasure. In Clip Studio Paint, you can ask the fill tool to not only ignore, but also fill in these gaps for you as you color. The five bars represent the size of gaps that the fill tool will be looking for. You can further specify a gap size value by clicking on the little arrow out here and type in a number. The gap size will differ depending on how small or big you draw your gaps. And it also depends on how big your canvas is, since gaps will be bigger the bigger your canvas is. So if you're using this feature, try with small gaps first, and if that is not enough, just adjust the gap size property accordingly until you find some kind of a sweet spot. Using a higher value of the close gap property may result in the fill tool not being able to reach narrow spaces in your Lineart, simply because it thinks there is a gap in your Lineart that it needs to close. To avoid this, the first thing we need to look for is to make sure you have a setting active called Fill Narrow Areas. You can check it by clicking the little plus icon next to the Close Gap property. If this icon is not there by default, simply go to the Window menu and select Subtool Detail. Here you can click the little eye icon to unhide any hidden properties. Once you make sure that Fill Narrow Areas is turned on, but the fill tool still cannot get to the narrowest part of your Lineart, just increase the value of the Tolerance property until you get the desired result. Which leads me exactly to the next subject, the Tolerance or Color Margin property. The tolerance, also known as the color margin, refers to the tolerance in the difference of colors when coloring or making a selection with the selection tool. The reason I mentioned the selection tool is because it also has a tolerance property and it works in the exact same way as the fill tool's tolerance. I'll try to explain this concept with some visuals. Look at this gradient. It goes from white and all the way to black. I now pick a color, set the tolerance to 60 and click in the white area. The fill tool now fills up a big chunk of the gradient's range with my color. if I change the tolerance down to 30, it fills less of the same range. And if I lower it even further to 5, it only fills a very small portion of the gradient's entire range. The value of the tolerance is set from the value of the pixel you click on. That means if you click in the black area instead of the white, like we did before, the tolerance runs from that point instead. In other words, the tolerance determines how close the next color has to be regarded as the same color. I know this can be quite hard to understand, so let me show an example with some colors. Here I have colored the hair and the skin on the character Jinx, and they're on the same layer. Say I want to change the hair color, but not the skin color. I pick the new color and fill it in with my fill tool by clicking on the hair. But the new hair color bleeds all the way into the skin. This happens because the tolerance of my fill tool is quite high. In other words, the fill tool does not distinguish between the hair color and the skin color. But if we lower the tolerance, the fill tool can now easily distinguish between the hair color and the skin color, making it possible to recolor the hair without affecting the skin. The amount of tolerance you'll need depends on your specific colors, so try some different settings to find some kind of sweet spot for your current drawing. The tolerance tool or the color margin property is especially helpful if your line art is not, well, solid and crisp. I often use a semi-transparent brush or a textured brush to line my artwork, which gives the line art kind of a blurry or uneven look if you zoom in. Sometimes I even use my Lineart brush to shade a bit, making it more difficult for the fill tool to fill entire areas, because it sees the shading as lines that it needs to separate the colors from. In those cases, you can turn the tolerance up when you use the fill tool. This also eliminates a lot of white or empty pixels along edges. And here's an example where lowering the tolerance value might be more helpful for you. If you're going to paint in some details on your character using only the colors and not line art, in this case I want to paint some stripes on Jinx's pants, you might experience the fill tool just coloring past your colored area, which is frustrating. But try to lower the tolerance in these cases, so Clip Studio Paint can now better differentiate between the base color and your detail color. A lower tolerance now lets me paint within the area between the two colors. The area scaling property. Another crucial property of the fill tool in Clip Studio Paint is the area scaling. Activating area scaling simply means that when you put down a color with the fill tool, the colored area will extend itself a little further, so you will avoid those nasty white and empty pixels by the border of your line art. Yuck! Looks so... bleh. It is important that your area scaling property is using the scaling mode called To Darkest Pixel. You can access the scaling property by clicking the little plus icon next to the area scaling property. To Darkest Pixel is probably your default setting though, but just check to make sure. This setting means that when you are using area scaling, the colored area will be extended, but only extends to the darkest pixel in your line art, preventing the color from overflowing past the lines. Here's an example with three individual sets of circles. The top circle have figure line art and the bottom ones have thinner line art. On the color layer below the line art layer, I will thin in the circles with different amounts of area scaling. In the first two circles, I turn area scaling off. In the next circles, I add the value of 5. And in the last ones, I max out the area scaling with the value of 20. Now when I lower the opacity of the line art layer, you can see how far the color has extended at the different area scaling values. Be aware that using high values of area scaling and tolerance simultaneously can give some results that require some cleanup. They sometimes even seem to work against each other, and a lot of artists consider these two properties to kind of be the same thing actually. However, that is not true, as the area scaling only extends colors, while tolerance determines which colors are considered different colors or the same color. But now that you know how both properties work, you can find a sweet spot for your drawing where these two properties supplement each other the best instead of fighting each other. And finally, I want to share a few features and tips on how to optimize your coloring workflow so you can color your artwork more efficiently. Tip number one, use Enclose and Fill to quickly create silhouettes for your colors. If you have a character or any other object that you quickly want to fill, instead of clicking all the little areas with the fill tool, select the sub-tool called Enclose and Fill. Just check to make sure that it refers to the correct layer. Pick your fill color and then simply draw an area outside the object you want to fill and let go of your mouse. Bam! Silhouette. Tip number two, patch up white or blank pixels quickly using the Paint Unfill Area tool. Sometimes even with the best fill tool settings applied, there will be areas that the fill tool simply cannot reach. In these cases, simply go to the subtool window again and select Paint Unfilled Area. Then simply mark the area where there are white or blank pixels and do not be afraid to draw outside of your line art. Clip Studio Paint is clever enough to know where you want to fill in your missing colors, which is exactly what this tool does. Tip number 3, turning off anti-aliasing when using the fill tool. To further avoid white or blank pixels along the edges of your colors is to turn off anti-aliasing when using the fill tool. You can turn it off in the Properties window. The difference between using and not using anti-aliasing are the little semi-transparent pixels that you can see here along the edge. Without anti-aliasing, it is easier for Clip Studio Paint to distinguish between the colors when using tolerance, and you'll avoid a lot of white or blank pixels by the border of the colored area. And lastly, tip number 4, changing all areas of the same color at the same time. If you want to replace all the colors of the same color, for instance the specific color used for the hair on the entire layer, simply uncheck the Apply to Connected Pixels Only option. And with the fill tool, you can now replace the specific color with a new one using a single click over the entire layer, whether the colored areas lie next to each other or not. Whew, okay, that was it. You guys should be mastering the fill tool in Clip Studio Paint now. Wait! Feel free to ask anything in the comments below. I'm always most active in the comments in the first 24 hours after uploading a video. So if you have any questions you want answered, make sure you have your notifications on and I'll do my best. The next video will be about 5 features that you're probably not using in Clip Studio Paint, but that you definitely should be. I hope you look forward to it. Remember to like, share and subscribe. Your support means everything to me. Until next time, take care. Bye! Thank you.